Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. For the first time in a long time, we're outside the house on a White Boy 7 Street 2 vlog. We're going to Los Angeles.
I always take a picture of where I park so I don't forget. I think we rely way too much on technology. But it's nice that I grew up like before the internet took over everything, but now you can just order an Uber on your phone. You can do everything. So, got to the airport a little early. I'm a little sweaty in my sweater. All right, I'll see you in Los Angeles, guys.
We made it. After a long day of travel, we're finally in the telly, ladies and gentlemen.
I left my house at 9:30, and I got here at 6:30 this time. So it's, I think, 9 hours of travel. I'm too tired to do the math. Someone might correct me in the comment section. I'll show you guys what we're dealing with for the next few days. This is my cribs tour for my Los Angeles trip. It's a pretty nice hotel. I like it a lot. Pretty small, but it's like high quality. Two beds. I'll let you guys know which one is better. And let's do it for the vlog. Woo! I remember as a kid, if we ever got a hotel with two beds, you would just go back and forth. But I'll show you my favorite thing about the hotel room. And I'm kind of jealous because I want this in my future house. I want a shower that comes not only from above, I think it's called a sunflower shower head, but I want it to come from my butt, my toenails, like all over the place, like a car wash. Bathroom door is pretty sick. Nice robe. $75 if you take it. I'm not taking that, Daisy. Anyways, little bench right there. Before, I would never unpack my clothes, but I'm gonna start unpacking my clothes. And here's a little travel tip too. Put something on your bag. This is just a ripped up shirt, but it kind of differentiates. Did I say that word right? Your bag from the other bags. Because, I mean, every bag's pretty like black. Like there's 10 bags in the carousel that look like that. But my day, it's 4:20 here. I am in California, but I think my day has got to consist of just resting. My ass, my literal ass is sore from sitting down so long today. So I think I'm just gonna rest and take advantage, full advantage, of this thing that I did not even know existed before, and it's called per diem. Basically, when a company flies you out somewhere, if they're a good company, they give you a per diem, which is an allowance for food. And I have, I think it's $75 to spend per day. And one time I had $150, we were popping bottles, going crazy, sushi, all types of stuff, but $75 is still pretty good. So I'm gonna order something to eat. I think I'm just gonna watch some Netflix or something and just rest for the day tomorrow. Like, these trips are tiring. Like, you get here day one and then you like rest and adjust. Like, that's what usually I do. I don't usually go out, and especially Los Angeles, it makes me sick when I go outside. I feel like I got a very sensitive nostril palate, and and like the air pollution and quality just does not sit right with me. So you get here a day early, then you have the event day one, day two, and then you leave on day three. And usually after the first day, you go out with the people you're with, or the second day after everything's done. Because if you go out after the first day, you get hungover, and then the second day sucks. I did that so many times, and I've learned from my mistakes. So I think I'm just gonna get some food and chill, lay on one of these two beds, and so I don't know how interesting the vlog content will be. We'll see what we get into, but honestly, when I travel, the first day I just like to sleep, the second day it's all business, and then the third day, that's when the fun happens, really. And then fourth day, you fly home in the morning, so that's kind of what we're dealing with. That's what this schedule is like. And the Hollywood Hills are in the background. I think the Hollywood sign is somewhere behind somewhere. I don't know. At least I get to see the mountains, because I like nature, and LA is like the total opposite of nature. I'd rather do that. I would rather take a trip to, like, the Grand Canyon or something, which I think I'm going to do this winter if everything goes as planned. But I made it here safe. Long day of travel. This is what I wore. Oh my god, let me show you one more thing. So I got these pants, and you can see my underwear through them. So I was very self-conscious. I don't think anyone's looking at my pockets. Don't be looking at my pockets. And but my underwear was showing. So I'm actually gonna take these pants off, because I'm not gonna I'll do it, not show you guys. But maybe there's a mirror I don't know about, because I'm not familiar with the area. Let me assess the situation for escape routes, okay? Well, now the window's open, so I'm not taking off my pants. Oh, it's super dark. So first day has been completed. Well, not completed yet, but I'm beated. So for me, it is completed. Let's see how much this water is. Is this free water, or how much do you guys think? $5? They can't even see it on camera because they're trying to scam. $5 for that, Voss. No, thank you. But I'm thirsty. And I don't like tap water. Especially not LA tap water. I don't know, I got this. Because every time I come out here, like, people. Okay, let me just finish off like this. So people are like, oh, white boy, you get to go to Germany, and oh, you get to do this, and you get to do that. Which is cool experiences, but, you know, I'm here working, I'm not here on vacation. Alright, everybody. Just ordered some sushi. That looks good. Classic California roll. I'm in Cali, why not? And, kind of a lot, I think, for one person, but this will do me all of today. It's only 6 o'clock, so I'm still beat, man. I've just been laying in this. I chose this bed, but I think I'm going to go over here because it has the cord for me. Oh, I didn't show you this. When you open it,
I'm used to go to places like this to see if they're just playing the game.
What's up, everybody? We just got done doing the Geostorm tournament. Warner Brothers flew us out here, and we had to sit on an ice chair, so I'm gonna just lay on the sidewalk and try to dry off my ass. It is soaking wet. Oh. That's my ass right there. There's my wet ass. Thick daddy. We are back in our hotel after the shoot. I took a shower. I was so wet and my pants were just, it felt gross because it was all by my crotch area. And, ugh. But, I ordered some food, a Kobe beef burger. I was just talking about these today. I had some in Hawaii and they were so good. And I found a place that had them, Fuddruckers. And I was so disappointed when I opened it, though, because it was just this. Because I like having everything on it. I like onions, pickles, lettuce, mayonnaise, everything. As a kid, I didn't, but now I love vegetables. I got a vanilla shake. I always get vanilla. I don't know. Is that weird? Because I feel like vanilla tastes the best, personally. Chocolate tastes really good. And then they have these crazy Oreo flavors. I like straight up vanilla because it tastes like melted ice cream to me, which is really good. So I'm just chilling. I wanted to get a flight home a little bit earlier. I'm not that much of an adventurous type, especially when it comes to Los Angeles. If it was probably, I think I mentioned this earlier, but if it was any other city, I'd probably do a little bit more. But I've seen a lot, I've done a lot, and there's a lot of freaking creeps. Let's look out the window. I see two back there. I talked to someone about this. So I was like, man, I like coming to these events, but I really don't like LA. And this is to somebody who lives here, and he was like, no one does, pretty much, for the most part. I'm sure there's people who like LA, but for me, I'm just going to chill in the hotel room, enjoy this burger. I got an early flight, successful trip. We did not win the competition, but I did not lose it either. So that's a win in my book, I guess. Let's be positive. Because the second way around, whew, like, they went through some stuff, like, a lot of, so I was here for Warner Brothers, the extreme weather gaming event. Warner Brothers brought me out here. I was sponsored by them. This video is not sponsored, this is just a vlog with the FTC, I just want to make sure. So we're out here, and we had a game and ice chairs and like wind blowing and lightning and thunder. It was pretty extreme, and at the end they just had everything. They were on the ice chairs, there was lightning, there was thunder, there was fog, you couldn't even see. It was a pretty cool experience, and I like doing stuff like this. I love the competition, even though it was a silly competition, like Rocket League. I don't play Rocket League, and it was still a really close game. It was 7-8, and this guy had goggles on, and everyone in the chat was like, it was unfair, and the caster's like, oh, it's unfair, and there's wind blowing in my eyes. He has just, like, bulletproof glasses on, goggles on, and I lose by 1 point in Rocket League. I felt a little salty about it, but then seeing what he went through the next round without his goggles, he kind of lost in the same way. He was up 8-2, and then someone came back on him. So that made me feel a little bit better without his goggles. I think it went a little bit different. So I'm running out of camera space, so see ya. And this is the conclusion of another successful Los Angeles trip with your host of the most, White Boy 7th Street. I saw my Jeep right away, I knew exactly where to go. I feel like I'm kind of becoming an expert traveler, or maybe I'm getting old or just mad at people in general. Because it took forever to deboard the plane. Like, I was waddling, they couldn't see me because I was in back of them, but man! I get it, if you're old, you can take your time, but some people are just fucking straight up stupid. They don't know how to get out a fucking plane and get their bag. It's not that... Oh my god. Anyways, overall, pretty good trip. Quick trip, 3 days there. The event was really cool. Thank you to Warner Brothers for taking me out there. Machinima, I think I've been with Machinima longer than probably anybody at this point, because I was on the second wave of partners to get approved and get a partnership with YouTube through Machinima, and then like just employees. I don't know if there's any employees that have been there longer than I've been partnered with Machinima. So we're gonna go home. Miss the cats, miss Kelly. I was all the way on level 6, so the Jeep was kind of easy to find. I guess it was super busy when I got here. I had to park all the way up here and then all the way in the back, but the exit's right there, so that's no big deal. I did park on this little thing, and I noticed when I was sitting in the Jeep, it was like moving every time somebody came across it. I'm a little out of breath right now because I just rush out the airport. I know exactly where I'm going. I'm like, okay, I want to get home right now. Pretty nice day. Pretty nice day. So thank you guys for watching the vlog. Let me know how you felt about it. It was a little bit more adventurous, not as much. I don't know. I don't like to leave the comfort of my hotel or house that much. But we're working on it. You can see Chicago maybe in the background. Okay, hopefully I have my keys to my car and I can get back home. So I'm gonna take off this hoodie. It's hot. I'm gonna get in the Jeep. And I'll see you next Sunday for another White Boy 7th Street 2 vlog. Headbutt!